Sarah, thanks for coming to join me on this little video.
Thank you.
What would you like to talk about in this session?
I'd like to explore ways that I can get a better work-life balance, I think, and maybe take advantage of some of the wellbeing activities that the Trust has on offer.
Right. Tell me a bit more about that then. How do you think that would look for you in terms of that difference from how it is now?
I think there's a couple of things. I think one, it perhaps help in the day and help sort of shut off the very busy and work, everyone really pressured, really good opportunities, but sometimes feels that things tip over into the evening, kind of worried about stuff at work. So I'm hoping that might help a bit with that, but I'm also aware of the fact I've seen some really good evidence of when people have been accessing the wellbeing activities in work, that's really positive. So I'd like to see myself doing that and then maybe sharing that with other people so people feel they can get out of the office and really start looking after themselves, because that has a much positive effect then on the type of support that we're trying to give to people.
So there's something about what you want to achieve out of this yourself for your own benefits, but also that you perhaps want to be a bit of a role model for others.
Yeah, really aware that since we've moved over, the Trust is really keen to promote wellbeing at work. I think some people have really accessed that, but I think it's got huge benefits for other social care. And I know I'm probably in some ways a worse person to look at in terms of working long hours and slipping into working at the weekend. And a lot of people do that, so I'm keen to get the benefits myself, but really try and be a better role model around for people. That you know, you come to work, do your absolute best, but actually it's really important that you have time outside of work to refresh and come back ready, and actually, you know, to enjoy your life outside of work as well.
Mm-hmm. So, as it stands at the moment, with the way that you're sort of managing your work life and your home life, what does that feel like during a sort of typical working week?
I suppose it varies, but if there's lots of things on in work, can feel quite tired, can feel that even when you're going home there's still lots of things that need to be done. For myself, kind of getting in the habit of thinking, well, I'll do that in the evening. Be good and say, well, actually I'm only going to work late a couple of nights a week. But that can then tip into other nights. And before you know it, you've gone to work, come home, done a bit of work, maybe watched a bit of TV and then gone back to bed and ready to start the next day. Similarly at the weekends, I suppose there's a sense that, and there's no pressure to do that at all, but you kind of feel, well, I could just use a bit of time at the weekend to catch up on work, whereas sometimes you come into work feeling a little bit tired the next day, really.
So you say there's no pressure to do it, but you do it.
It's probably pressure yourself. Yeah, that's not even me, because I'm quite keen to get everything sorted and you know, want to keep on top of things. But I think starting to learn that actually working longer is not necessarily long hours and not the most effective.
Right.
Because actually, if you're looking after yourself, and that's a really important thing, I think, in the Trust, is, you know, taking care of each other and taking care of yourself. So, you know, be at your best and have your best day, really. And I think I'm starting to acknowledge that my best day isn't when I'm working from 7:30 in the morning through to 8:00 at night.
Right.
So, and I, you know, I'd like to try and change that, because I don't think it necessarily equates to doing more work or being more effective.
No. So, what do you think would be different in terms of how you might approach your work if your work-life balance was different? So imagine for yourself what that might look like. So we've addressed this balance so that you feel that you are able to separate out those times more clearly. How would that manifest itself? How would it feel for you? What would that look like?
I suppose when you get a good work-life balance, you do feel that the two things are separate. So you come to work, you're working, you know, really effectively, you feel like you're achieving quite a lot, but actually you're also stopping at a certain time and actually going home and doing other nice things. So it does feel a bit separate like that. Easier to manage, I think, in reality, because you do feel refreshed. So, you know, for me it'd be no problem sort of working early but not working late every night. And also camp protected times at the weekends to do nice things. But also in work as well, you know, when you get a chance to take lunch and, you know, take some of the benefits of some of the activities that are available, because I think it's really easy just to get your head down and not look up and see what else is going on actually with your colleagues and your friends and you know, try and enjoy that. And I think it just makes you feel better in yourself.
So if in this future where your balance between life and work is better, if we were to ask a colleague about that, if they'd noticed any differences, do you think there would be, what do you think they'd be saying? What would you like them to be?
So I think I'd have to say, there's Sarah, you know, yeah, is in early in the morning, but not necessarily last person out at night. You know, is able, gets through a lot of work, really good at managing pressures, but knows it's important to kind of take breaks and encourage other people to do that. You know, and has a really good life outside of work as well. And I'd like people to say, you know, there's someone who really promoted and championed the well-being and taking care of each other in work. I'd like people to think that. That took time to listen to people and make sure people are okay and value them, because I think that's really important.
Mm-hmm. So there would be a tangible difference, do you feel, then?
I suppose internally, absolutely, yeah, but it's difficult because you never know quite how people see you. You like to see people think, oh, there's someone who works really hard, but I'd like people to see me as somebody who really went out the way to sort of promote well-being, and I think I do, I try to, but I'd like to be someone who was seen to be really champion that, because you know, since I've come to the trust and I've seen the benefits that it can have, you know, and how hard the job is for everybody, and I'm really keen to do that.
So you've talked quite a lot then really there about how you can see it would have benefits for you in terms of being able to separate out your day more, around the way that you might work when you're in work, but also the impact on colleagues if you like sort of championing well-being and breaking up the work in the appropriate ways. So it feels as though it's a really compelling sort of vision. So it's something, you know, you'd really want to achieve. So what do you think could help you to get to that point then?
I think maybe having a bit of a plan to do certain things and sticking to it, trying to stick to it, because it's very easy for other priorities to come in the day. And so when I've, you know, tried to stick to things, I think, well, you know, I'm definitely going to do yoga 3 times a week, and I'm definitely going to go for a walk at lunchtime, and I'm definitely going to go and, you know, go to a relaxation class or mindfulness. It's easy to let other things, sort of priorities, sway past that. Sometimes you have to do that, but I think having a plan really helps, you know, and trying the best you can to stick to it. And I think giving myself kind of permission to do that, and you know, you don't necessarily have to be working every hour to be super. And people don't expect you to do that. You know, most of the pressure will be from myself, so it's actually giving myself permission to think, well, you know what, I'm at my most effective when I'm taking proper breaks and then looking out for myself and looking after my colleagues. So I think, yeah, plan, a weekly plan maybe.
So So you've identified a couple of possible sort of options for yourself there. One obviously being the plan, saying you'd set yourself a plan. But then the other, there was a big thing there about giving yourself permission to stick to it and keep it as sacred as you can in terms of it being something that you do.
Mm.
So how committed do you think you could be to doing that? A, to writing the plan. We took that first of all.
I think really committed to writing the plan.
So if it was out of 10.
Yeah, a good 9. To write the plan,
And in terms of giving yourself some sort of permission to do that, what might that look like? What do you feel you need to do that's perhaps different to what you do now?
I think probably it's okay to give yourself permission. I think the challenge that I've got is that I also have a sense of worrying about things I've perhaps got to do and wanted to make sure I've covered everything. And because I'm quite a detailed, organised person, I like to be organised with my work. And so the commitment to that can kind of challenge the commitment to taking breaks, I think, and that's a bit of a rub up. So give myself permission, that's certainly quite high motivation. It's just managing the what happens when the pressure's on, or you know, think, oh, I could just stay and do that, or actually just do that.
Yeah.
That's probably my biggest challenge.
So that's about your, how did you describe it then? A sense that if you've got pressures, that they must come first.
Mm-hmm.
I think so. I'd like to think that you've perhaps agreed that you can give me a 9 out of 10 to actually write your plan.
Yeah.
I wonder whether perhaps if we were to meet again and discuss this, say in a month's time, what do you think you might want to sort of talk to me about with relation to that at that point? I think around the permissions, for example.
I'd like to have a plan in place. I'd like to be able to say, well, certainly on this week kept most of the plan. I think there'll probably be times when I don't, and that's actually okay, because you can't be so rigid, and you know we need to be able to be flexible. But I'd like to be in a position where I perhaps felt less guilty for myself if I didn't stick to the plan. So if I needed to do something at the weekend, or actually, you know, that would be a good place, I think. And you know, I'd like to be in a position to say, you know, and I talked to these colleagues or these colleagues and myself when we did this wellbeing activity, you know, and really championed that across the trust. So I'd like to have some sort of tangible examples of that, benefits,
Well, let's see where that gets us to next time then.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much, Sarah.
Appreciate it.